Hello, my loves, it's Monica, and today I am going to be doing a fairy core transformation video. I've got my wig, I've got lots of makeup, and we're just going to get right into it. Yeah, it's been a minute since I've done like a full makeup kind of video on this channel, and I've just been really wanting to recently. I've been really inspired. Spring is here, so I'm just wanting to do some magical spring makeup. So I'm starting off by priming the face, and I prime just using moisturizer because that's basically what I want out of a primer, is I just wanted to add some more moisture to my face so that everything goes on nice and smoothly. So I am using the COSRX Advanced Snail 92 All-in-One Cream. This is my daily moisturizer that I use in the morning, and it's super like stringy. It's very strange texture wise, but I love this stuff. This was actually sent to me by YesStyle. And then I also apply a little bit of eye cream. This is the Benton Fermentation Eye Cream. You don't need an eye cream, in my honest opinion, but I like to apply just a little bit before I apply makeup because I think it just, again, everything just sort of sits better on the face, in my opinion. This one was also sent to me by YesStyle. So now that I have all of that on, I'm going to color correct. So I have a lot of like redness in my face, and that's something that I just like to try and conceal a bit. So I'm using the Innisfree Mineral Makeup Base, and this is a green color corrector, so it cancels out that redness. And I only use like a tiny bit of this stuff, but I just apply it in those spots where I have a lot of redness. And then I'm not super concerned about blending it all in because I'm about to apply my foundation, and I use a pretty light foundation. I really like the Pretty Fresh from ColourPop. It's a tinted moisturizer, and I just think it looks really nice on the skin. And I don't mind that you can see like any acne or acne scarring, you know, I more so just want to even out my skin tone. So now I just use my concealer and I go in on any like real things that I want to cover. Okay, so one thing that I've kind of learned over time is that I have like sort of a crease under my eye because it's like puffy there, so I cannot apply concealer right there. So I usually apply it elsewhere, and then I'll take whatever's left over on my finger and I apply it into that area. But yeah, that's just my little tip. If you cannot get things to not crease under your eye, that's how I do it. I'm gonna go in with contour, and I'm using the Fenty Matchstick, and I'm using the color Amber, which is the lightest shade. And I don't do a ton with this, but I just kind of apply it here and then here in the hopes of bringing some color back into my face. And then I'll do a little here, the tip of my nose, and the sides of my nose. Now I'm gonna use some blush, and I have been loving this from Rare Beauty. It is the color Joy. It's so beautiful. These blushes are amazing. Now I will say that these are crazy pigmented, which I think is amazing because I think that it allows the blushes to be used by a wider variety of people, and I love that. But I just wanted to point that out in case you ever pick these up. You gotta be really careful because it's so easy to overdo it. So I just do one dot, okay, one dot on my nose. And honestly, that dot on my nose, probably a bit too much, but we'll make it work. And then you can use your finger or a beauty blender. I usually start off with my finger, and like, look at that. But I love this color because it's such a pretty like peachy red pink shade. And then I use my beauty blender to soften it a little. And honestly, probably if you aren't as keen on blush as I am, you'd probably use even less than I used, but I really want you to see my blush, you know? Apply a little bit going across my nose. I actually ended up wiping off a good chunk from the tip of my nose because that was definitely, it would have been too much. But I removed that, and I'm just gonna apply a bit onto my chin. And I'll even take a little because I have some left over, and I'll apply it around my mouth. Ugh, I love this blush. It's amazing. It's so good. And then my final cream face product is just an eye primer. So now that all of my cream products are on my face, I'm gonna go ahead and set a little bit with powder. Now it is time for my favorite part, which is nose contour, and I use powder for this. Obviously, I did a bit of contour with a cream product. Now we're gonna do the real stuff. So now I'm gonna go into this like medium, like cool tone brown shade, and it's Wedge from MAC. And I'm gonna use this to start carving out the shape of my nose that I want for this look. Now, here's what I will say about this nose contour look that I'm doing. It's very much so more for like taking videos or photos. I don't know if I'd wear it this intense when I'm just going out and about because it is more obvious, but you know what? Life is short. Then I go ahead in and I apply that right onto the bridge of my nose. Now for round two, I'm going in with an eyebrow shadow actually, and it's the Benefit Browsing. And it's just a darker brown. It doesn't have to be this. So this is just an Eco Tools brush, and it's like flat but fluffy, and I think it's really good for contour because of that. And I just go in with this darker brown, and I use that where I really want like to darken, which is just like around the tip basically. There's a lot of brown on my nose. So I'm gonna go in with this really hard to open ColourPop blush that I love. It is beautiful. And this is in the color Love Me Not, and it's heart-shaped. It's like a, I don't know, like a warm red color, browny red color. And I'm just gonna go ahead and like take the flat side of this brush, and I'm gonna use that to just like apply right across the bridge of my nose where that brown is, basically just to like warm it up and have it look like blush. And I'm gonna go into in it with a actual blush brush and use that to apply a bit onto the bottom of my nose. So it's a kind of extreme look, not for everybody, but I love it, especially when everything's together. I think it's adorable. Yeah, and then I'm gonna take that blush, and I'm actually gonna apply a little bit more blush just here, just stamp it on with that. Then I'm going in with one of my favorite face products. This is from the brand Pseudo Labs, and it is a freckle product. It's my favorite of all of the freckle products, I think. I don't know, I'm thinking about doing like a TikTok or reel about like all the freckle products that I've tried, because I've tried a lot. But this one, you can use it a couple different ways. So it's like, it's on like a mascara brush almost. And the way you're supposed to use it is that you use this wand and you like flick it and it splatters on your face and it looks really natural. That's cute and everything. I just use the tip of this and I apply it straight on. So I just dab it on right where that like dark shadow is and then tap it out. So now that I have my brown freckles on, I'm gonna apply some white freckles because we're a fairy today. So I'm gonna apply these just with a white eyeliner. And I usually have to go over this a couple times because the Sephora one isn't the greatest, but I just dab this all over. And then I'm also gonna take that eyeliner and apply a little bit onto my highlight areas. Now we are finally gonna get onto the eyes, and I'm using two different ColourPop palettes today. I'm using the Mint to Be and Lilac You a Lot. I like both of these. The Mint to Be especially is phenomenal, one of my favorite palettes. So I'm gonna start off with the color Mint Tea, which is this one right here. And then I'm going into Mojito Mommy, this one, this light mint shade, and I'm gonna apply that on the inner area. Now I'm gonna go in with a big fluffy blending brush and I'm gonna do a quick blend of that. And now I'm gonna go into this purpley pink color, which is called Ghostin'. And I want to like kind of extend that purple out a bit. And I'm gonna apply a bit of that under my eye. I'm gonna go back into that mint palette and I'm just going to top up that mint color. So for my eyeliner, I do a very specific shape. Instead of going up, like doing the cat eye liner, I follow the like natural curve of my eye and I go down. This is often called puppy liner because it like looks cute, like puppy dog eyes. And I really like the way it looks. It's not gonna be for everybody, but yeah, I bring it down. I bring it down pretty far. And then I add some like fake lashes onto the bottom and some like actual fake lashes on the top. And the lashes are really what brings it together. Like it looks a little weird until I put fake lashes on. And honestly, probably to some people it looks weird even with fake lashes, but I don't care. I love it. I think it's cute. So yeah, I'm gonna go in with my eyeliner. I just use the ColourPop BFF liquid liner in black. Okay, see, it's going down. Then I go from like the middle of my eye and I bring that out. And I usually leave that like inner corner blank. So again, it looks a little weird without the lashes, but just give it a second. And now that I look like a full raccoon, I'm gonna go in and apply some lashes onto the sides. And then I do a little bit of an inner corner. So now that I have the eyeliner done, I'm gonna go and do a little bit of contouring around the eye. So I'm gonna go in with that eyebrow powder and a small brush, and I'm just gonna do that right under my eye. And that's because, again, I have like puffiness under my eye and I like to exaggerate it. And I'm gonna go into this super shimmery green mint highlight color and I'm just gonna apply that on that like center area for some highlight. And I'm gonna take a white eyeliner and I'm going to apply that onto my waterline. And I'm also going to apply it onto that space that I left empty in here. So now I'm gonna apply my fake lashes, and I love this lash glue. It's from Kiss. It is a liner lash glue, and it's just so much easier than regular lash glue. Okay, now you see how the lashes makes it a little less like wild looking, in my opinion, or it makes it just work together. For my brows, I just use the Glossier Brow Flick, and I flick on some brows real quick. And then I just use the Glossier Boy Brow to fluff up my brows a little bit. Okay, we're done with the face makeup. Now I am going to apply lip stuff. And then we're gonna get on to the wig and the ears and the dress. So I have a very specific way that I do my lips. So I'm starting off by just blotting off that lip balm. And I'm gonna go in with that ColourPop blush in Love Me Not. And I'm gonna go in with this small blending brush. All of my brushes for the most part are from ColourPop, like one of their sets, or Eco Tools or e.l.f. So yeah, so I'm gonna go in with some of that. So basically what I do is I go around my lips with the blush, and I do that just to kind of like overline my lips but in a really soft way. And then I use that brown liner or that brown shadow that I use to contour my nose and eyes with, and I use that to contour the sides of my mouth a bit, just to kind of fake that my mouth turns up a little bit more. And then I also use a little bit of that to add some shadows above and below my lip. Now that that's done, I'm gonna go in with a lip tint. This is the Dear Darling tint from Etude House, and I'm gonna apply that into the inner part of my lip. And then once that's set, I'm just gonna use a lip gloss and I'm gonna apply that right on top. So I can't believe I almost forgot about this, but I have to apply highlight, obviously. So I'm using this Ofra Cosmetics one in the shade Pillow Talk. And it's just like a super shiny pink highlight. All right, so I have finished the makeup. Now I'm gonna apply my wig cap and my wig. So once I have my wig cap on, I just use some like hair clips and I pin back this part. So this wig I got from a brand called Donna Love Hair, and it was actually super long. I chopped it because I couldn't handle how long it was, and it is a synthetic wig, but it's like you can use heat on it. Hello. Okay, so I have my wig on and my makeup done. Now I'm gonna pick out a dress that I think will fulfill my fairy dreams. This one is always a favorite. It's so pink and sparkly. It has like glittery stars all over it. So I do love that. Or my Selkie rainbow dress. I think I'm gonna do this because actually the eyeshadow matches the colors in this dress and I just love that. So I think this is the one we're gonna wear today. And now the ears. I've seen people who have like pierced their elf ears and I really wanna do that because it looks so cute. For my earrings, I'm gonna mix two. I have, both of these are from a small indie creator called Tiny Made. And then I have this handful of butterfly clips. So I'm gonna go ahead and attach these to my hair. Hello friends, so this is the end of the video. I had so much I had so much fun putting together this fairy core inspired look. And yeah, this was just a fun way to spend the day in my opinion. I will try to link everything that I mentioned or used in this video down below in case you want to check anything out. And yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video and be sure to subscribe if you would like to see more videos from me, whether that be about books or fashion or whatever. And I'll talk to y'all later. Bye!